So I got this question the other day. Will consuming coconut oil raise my cholesterol? So let's just talk about it. The answer is yes, it might, but who cares? There is absolutely no research anywhere that shows any negative aspects of consuming coconut oil on your heart. There's no data that shows that even if your cholesterol goes up from coconut oil, that you're going to have a heart attack or any risk factor at all for having a heart problem. Now, if you happen to see a study, make sure you read it because it'll be on mice and they will also have something else in the diet, which is usually glucose or sucrose, which is sugar. But if you're actually just talking about coconut oil, you're not going to increase the risk for heart problems at all. Okay, so here's the thing. When you consume coconut oil, there's fat in there, okay? It may temporarily increase your cholesterol, but here's the key point. It's not about the total cholesterol. It's usually about the LDL, okay? Low density lipoprotein. They call this the bad cholesterol. Well, here's the thing. There is two types of LDL. One is the small dense particles, and the other version is the large buoyant particles, which are, they float. And what determines if you have the small dense particles, which can invade the wall of the artery and create a lot of inflammation and problem, has to do not with your coconut oil or cholesterol or fat, it has to do with your carbs. If your carbs are high, the LDL type you'll have is a small dense, okay? If you don't have these refined carbs, so you go low carb, you may have high LDL, but it'll be the large, buoyant type LDL. A simple test to do would be to get an advanced lipid profile test and determine what type of LDL you have. Then you'll know for sure. But because coconut oil has certain fats that are called medium chain triglycerides, okay, typically what happens is your triglycerides will go down. Your good cholesterol, your HDL, will go up, and the most important thing is your insulin will come down. You'll improve that condition called insulin resistance. You'll make insulin more sensitive so it can work better. And because of that, you're going to not end up with small, dense, low-density lipoproteins, okay? It's not going to affect the heart. What's really behind the damaging effect of the heart is the insulin, and that comes from carbs, not fat. I hope I explained that very simply, but when you really understand that there's two different types of LDL, then it makes a lot of sense. All right, thanks for watching. So I just spent the last 2 months creating this amazing course called How to Bulletproof Your Immune System. And there's 21 different lessons, and I want to give you this course for free. And the problem I have with giving it free is sometimes people don't value it as much, but I want to get it out there. So I'm just going to give it to you free, and I want to let you know that it's extremely, extremely valuable. Right now, we're in a situation of uncertainty. They're talking about a second wave, and other people are waiting for this miracle vaccine that may be safe. Who knows? It's all unknown. So what is the big elephant in the room? No one is talking about the immune system. They're not emphasizing the most important thing that you can do to bulletproof yourself against viruses and bacteria. This course is going to lay out things in 21 different lessons. I'm going to teach you very simply what your immune system is and exactly what you can do to strengthen it using natural things. There are three requirements. Number one, I want you to share it very, very widely. Can you imagine if thousands of people had this information to protect themselves? But not only that, getting rid of the fear factor, which I believe is worse than the virus. I mean, when you think about it, it's very similar to someone being bullied in school. As soon as they learn self-defense, they're going to be less adversely affected by these bullies. So why not give you the information on your immune system so you know what to do to protect yourself? You see a lot of people that are scared. I see them when I exercise, like in the park, they're wearing a mask while they're exercising or walking by themselves. Or in a car, they're wearing a mask and a shield. So please share this course with everyone you know. If you want to help someone, this is the best way to help them, to give them the knowledge of how to strengthen their immune system. We want this to go viral. in a healthy way. All right, number two, be active on your course and actually complete the course, okay? Take your time, really learn the information. There's questions that you're gonna have to answer, but stick with it. And number three, send me your success when you complete the course. And sometimes when I talk to people, they end the conversation with, be safe. And I thought to myself, what does that mean, be safe? Well, wear the mask and also avoid getting too close to people, right? Well, that's cool, but what about strengthening the immune system? That way you could be not just safe, but you could be very, very smart, because the missing link is a strong immune system. That gives you the ultimate protection. I really believe that the best thing that we can do, both you and I, to help people is to spread this out and get everyone to know this information. And here's what I came up with. For the top three people that share this course with the most people, I'm gonna give them a 1 hour one-on-one video consult with Dr. Berg, myself. And we can talk about anything, or your health, or whatever. And then for the top 100 people that share this course, I'm gonna give this group video access to a very special webinar that's gonna be live on a topic that I can't necessarily do in a YouTube video because it'll be taken down, but just realize it's gonna be some very powerful information that you're gonna learn that's gonna really help you and people around you. Sorry to give you that mystery, but unfortunately, social media is filtering out certain topics right now. And the top 100 will also get access to my virtual keto summit at the end of August. Last point, to get access to this information, you have to have Messenger. Now, some of you don't use Messenger, and unfortunately, everything is set up on Messenger. So I would recommend signing up on Messenger, and if you don't want to continue to use it after the course, just opt out. I think you're really going to enjoy this course. I put a lot of time into it. The information is down below. And spread the word.